You think about a traditional clock, like a pendulum clock. It's based on some periodic event, and in that case, the pendulum swinging back and forth. To generate time from that, you just count cycles of this oscillator. For atomic clocks, it's really not much different at all. You can think about some characteristic vibration in an atom, and you build a device that somehow measures or can synchronize to those oscillations. Have an oscillator that generates radiation, and that radiation is at some particular frequency that you can tune to one of the natural oscillations in the atom to generate time from that. The simplest way is if the radiation is tuned in synchronism with these natural vibrations, and that radiation is absorbed. When you find out when that condition of maximum absorption, then you simply count cycles of this oscillator that's producing the radiation. And the only sort of technical difference is that as opposed to a pendulum clock that's oscillating maybe once every other second or so, we're talking about oscillation frequencies of about 10 to the 10th cycles per second. And now we can make much more accurate clocks if we go to high frequencies. So now about 10 to the 15th cycles per second. One of the nice things about atoms as opposed to pendulum clocks is that, as far as we know, all atoms, say, of a given type are exactly identical. So as opposed to a pendulum clock, as good as we might be able to make, say, the length of the pendulum be the same on different clocks, we can never do that precisely. So there's errors in one clock versus another. An atomic clock based on one atom, if we agree on a convention, you know, some transition that we're going to measure, to the degree we can measure these transition frequencies, the frequencies are exactly identical.